Hey, this is Eric from DrummerConnection.com, and today we're going to discuss a series of hearing protection and monitoring products. In this review, I'm going to cover a series of products from any budget range, and the most important thing I want to point out to you is that I am not paid to do this review, all right? These products I've obtained at my own free will, and I've spent a lot of money doing that, and over the last 2 or 3 years that I've used most of these products, I've come to some conclusions, and I'd like to share those with you in this product review. So just remember that hearing is the most important thing that we need to protect as a drummer. We're around extreme 100 plus decibel levels of sound that can cause tinnitus, ringing in the ears, severe ear pain, puncturing of the eardrum, and so forth. So it's very important that we always protect our hearing, even if you think you're going to be around the drums for just a few seconds. You know, the first thing that you always have is going to be your fingers. Just push your earlobes back and you plug your ears. The next thing is going to be cheapo foam earplugs. 10 bucks at the hardware store. I got 50 pair of these things. They're purple for what that's worth. And they squeeze into your ear and they protect them very well. I carry at least 2 or 3 pairs of these in my backpack and I try to have them around at all times. You know, so this is the cheapest possible way for you to protect your hearing as a drummer. The next thing we're going to talk about is the hardware store hearing protection devices. What do you call these? Earmuffs. These are about $7 to $25, maybe $30 at the store. They have no speakers inside. There's no cables. These are just to protect your hearing. So they fit very good depending on which brand you got. These are Peltors, Ultimate 10s. And I recommend that you have a pair of these as well. $7 to $30. These are well worth the investment. Now, iPod earbuds. These are not good for drumming, and you know, up until recently, they've never really been comfortable. But you know, they come with all your iPods, iPhones, iPads, everything. So everybody's got them. And if you're going to use something like this, you know, you put them in. I recommend you route the cable behind you some way, and then put these on top of them. And there you go. You have extreme isolation, and you have iPod earbuds for a decent sound in your ears, a sound that you're comfortable with. So, and you can also hear the drums over that depending on the level of your iPod earbuds. So there you go. There's a homemade solution real quick before we move on and talk about all these professional products. The next product we're going to talk about is Direct Sound EX25 Extreme Isolation Headphones. Now these are the ones with the red and the black ears. And I tell you what, you know, these are great. They're $89.95 a pair, depending on where you get them from, Musician's Friend, so forth, Guitar Center, you know, wherever you can find them, your local music shop. But the problem with me is the headband has always been problematic. And the sound that comes out of them is kind of hollow sounding, a lot of mid-range, a lot of high-end, and it tends to burn my ears the longer I use these. So I get a lot of ear fatigue on my outer ear and my inner ear by using these isolation phones. However, I do know plenty of drummers who swear by these over anything else, and you know, they're good for whoever likes them, but to me, not for the price. I just don't really care for these all that much. The next pair we're gonna talk about is the most common one that I've seen and the one that I've grown to love and I've used for many, many years, and that's the Vicfirth isolation headphones. These are about $59.95 at all your music stores. They're extremely comfortable. They kind of remind me of aviation headphones. And I mean, I can tell you stories about aviation, but this is the headphone if you want to do any kind of isolation. They fit comfortably. They're snug. They got a good spring action in the headband. They fit very well. They rest upon your ear more so than the extreme isolations. And they really cut the sound down to about 20, 25 decibels. So you still be able to hear your drums on top of these. I'm probably talking really loud because I have them on. You'll still have your drums on top of these, and you'll be able to mix them in by moving the earmuff back and forth on your head. So you know, if you can imagine, you have them on, just kind of move this muff around until you can hear your drums. So you can kind of mix with both of these isolation headphones. So Vicfirth, I highly recommend them. In fact, I have not only one, two, three, four pairs of them, and I've had them all for at least 5 years, 4 years, and they all work. So highly recommend the Vic Firths over anything for a cheap budget. Now, the problem with these kind of headphones, like I said, you get a lot of ear fatigue. It tends to make my ears, my outer ear burn. And you know, they don't really have a lot of low end in them. The low end seems to be there, but it's like flat and it's just missing a lot of sound. So, you know, they're good if you have the bass player in the room with you and the amp is cranked up and you can actually hear the and feel the external bass. These are awesome. And you know, so are the Direct Sound EX25s. So under $100, that's what you got. And you know, we'll just, you know, recommend these for anybody who's interested in protecting their hearing and getting a good sound. Oh, and by the way, you're gonna look like Mickey Mouse wearing these on stage. So with that being said, let's talk about the custom in-ear monitors. Custom in-ear monitors are, you know, you see them on, you know, when you're watching musicians live, you see them on TV and so forth. You don't see any big bulky headphones like this on top of them. And they're usually wearing custom molded in-ear monitors. So from about $20, we move up to about the $800 range. Now there's other in-ear monitors before this that aren't as expensive, but this is the three driver custom in-ear solutions from Ultimate Ears, and I also have a set of Gorilla Ears right here. So Gorilla Ears and Ultimate Ears, they both make excellent quality products, and they both fit very well. They both have three drivers, and it just depends on which brand you really want. Right now, I used the Ultimate Ears for over a year, and until recently, I haven't had any problems with them other than the ear attachment cables falling off, and we'll talk about that in just a second. But Ultimate Ears comes with a really sturdy, heavy-duty case. I ordered this set in clear, and my cable was clear. I ended up replacing the cable recently because it broke. And you know, they're just custom molded. They have my initials right there on them, and you know, they fit extremely well. When you pop these things on, they seal your ear up, and it's magic. You know, you hear all the low end, you hear all the high end, you hear everything that you want to hear within music. And these are great for wearing with your iPod. I am the first person to admit that I don't just use my in-ear monitors on stage or anything like that. I use them everywhere. I walk with them, I mow my yard with them as well, and I've done other things. Now, the company that's impressed me the most recently is Gorilla Ears. They've come out of the gate and they've got some great products, and you can't really tell the difference between Ultimate Ear and a Gorilla Ear. I mean, there's not much of a difference. My fit is snug. The casing seems like it's a little bit firmer and harder. And there's, you know, they made these for me. They're blue and my favorite color and clear, and they look really cool when they're in. With the Gorilla Ears, the one thing I noticed is that the this ear molding part right here is shorter. So this actually sits behind my ear right up here now, and it makes it a little uncomfortable at first, but once you get used to it, it's fine. So when you pop these things in, they fit snug, they fit very well, and they sound amazing. So these are my primaries. This is what I'm using right now. This is what I'll reach for first, and this is what I will use until they break or until I burn them out. Gorilla Ears are my favorite. Ultimate Ears are my backup. And then from there, I'm gonna get into grabbing the nearest pair of isolation headphones I can find. So all these products are out there on the market. These are the three driver series. They're the mid-range budget series. And it's important to know that, you know, there's a lot of companies out there, and it just boils down to support and you know, the relationship that you build with a custom in-ear company. Gorilla Ears has been awesome to me. They followed up. They've been very persistent. I reported a little bit of an issue with how snug the fit is with my Ultimate Ear. I'm sorry, with my Gorilla Ears. And you know, they basically persistently emailed me back and asked me to send them to them so that they could trim them down for me, which, you know, that's important. I've just adapted to wearing them, and I just like how they fit. I like how they sound, and they look, you know, pretty cool. So Gorilla Ears, the other bonus for grill ears, and I'm gonna remind you of this, is make sure you order a longer cable than usual. This is a 3-foot cable. The UEs came with, I believe, like an 18 inch or a 2-foot cable. And whenever I'm trying to change the song on my iPod, because I put the cable down the back of my shirt, I try to change the song on my iPod, I'm stuck like right here. So I have to, like, you know, with the Ultimate Ears. So there you go. There's two custom molded in-ear companies that I've reviewed. I've used Ultimate Ears for over a year with the UE7 Pros, great product. Now I'm using the Gorilla Ears GX3B series, 3 drivers a piece on each of the ears. They all have the same specifications roughly. And I just really like the Gorilla Ears. I like the way they fit, I like the way they feel, I like the way they sound, and I like the fact that they have a longer cable. And they're holding up very, very well for me. So if you're in the market for some custom molded in-ears, keep in mind that, you know, I have the mid-range. So around $850 is what each of these would cost you. They have cheaper ones, you know, $300 to $400, $500 range. Also Shure and Sennheiser, they also offer, the universal ones where you can just change out the in plugs, stick them in your ear and use them temporarily. So, you know, if you want to save some money there, they also have, you know, in the $200 to $300 range, even cheaper. So do your research, find out what works best for you. These just happen to be what I've come across and what I use. So, you know, I recommend pretty much all these products depending on what your budget is. As a bonus, I want to remind you that, you know, having control over the sound going straight into your ears is extremely important. Regardless of, you know, the mixing, the monitoring, all that stuff out there, having a Presonus HP4 amp right in front of you will give you control right here. It's kind of like your kill switch. It's like your personal monitoring level. So when you're using in-ear monitors, this is extremely important. When you're using the Vic Firths, this is extremely important because you can really crank up the level or turn it down if you have in-ears. There's a couple other things I'll point out. Having extreme isolation headphones is good because if you hit yourself in the head with the drumstick, they will protect you. If you hit yourself in the ear with a drumstick with one of these things in, it's like getting hit in the head with a sledgehammer. It hurts. It literally hurts. It'll bring tears to your eye and it'll make you want to stop drumming for the rest of the day. It's painful. So, you know, be careful when you're using these professional in-ear monitors that are jammed into your ears. And control your drumstick, you know, practice stick control and all that good stuff, and you'll be okay. So that being said, this is all the products I can think of to review for you right now. And I hope this information has helped, and I look forward to any kind of comments you might have on the YouTube video. So leave me a comment right below the YouTube video and I'll get back to you with any questions you may have. And again, great props to all these products. They're all superior design, excellent quality. And I'm hoping that, you know, this review will help you make a decision. So good luck out there. Protect your hearing. Stay tuned. Some really cool stuff's coming down the pipe from drummerconnection.com. And have a happy holidays.